Hello everyone, Colorado 8 here, and today I'm back with another video, and a different type of video. If you guys looked at my last video, I commented down below if you guys wanted me to show you guys how I make my thumbnails. You guys actually liked the comment like 20 times, that the comment got 20 likes, so I'm gonna do the video for you guys, and show you guys how to make your own thumbnail. So, what you wanna do is take a screenshot of your weapon you actually want to choose. So, for this, one right here, I'm gonna choose dual laser blasters. Actually, I'm gonna choose a primary weapon for this, or yeah, so I'm gonna take a picture of which one do I want, which one is not super hard to actually do. All right, we're gonna take a picture of the Hellraiser, take a screenshot of this right here, and I'll show you guys how to download the app of what you want to do this by, and just basically how to actually do it. So I'll see you guys there. So after you're taking your screenshot of your weapon, so you're gonna download this app called Photoshop Touch right here. It's the blue app under Skype for me. So what you need to do is download this app called Tutu App, and you guys can look up a tutorial on YouTube on how to download it. I'm not gonna do it in this video because it'll take way too long, and probably in another 5 extra minutes. This app also has tons of ads, actually. It's kind of annoying. So what you do is look up Photoshop Touch in your little bar here, and you'll see it. It says Adobe Photoshop Touch. It should be the first one that pops up. And on the bottom left, corner, it says open. That button should say download, and you have to wait for it to download. So after you have done that, after it's done downloading, you have to go to the app now. And so what you do here is that you go into photo library, press the this button that has a little photo on it, press photo library and click on moments, and you click on the weapon you actually chose, and I chose the Hellraiser. And so what you do is zoom in on the weapon itself, and what you do is that I like using the this little section right here. Choose a box one, that's the best one to use. And I recommend using the boss one because it's probably the easiest to do. Now, just zoom in on the weapon, like get the whole weapon pretty much, at least the whole weapon. And click the button on the right of done, on the top right. And click extract, this button here. As you can see here, I pretty much extracted pretty much everything except for the part I actually zoomed in on. So, click on the magic on option right here. Alright, sorry about that. So basically what you do is use your magic wand and click on the blue parts of the picture here. Just click on this button on when you actually extracted it and press the clear button. And do it for everything else until you actually have only the weapon on the screen. As you can see here, you try to do it right here on the swipe up words. It's going to not do it super fast actually. So what you do for that part, I'm going to show you guys what you do. Alright, so basically, you have to deselect actually when you do it. You're gonna use the eraser tool, and you're gonna just erase everything up on the weapon, because you can't get everything from the magic wand, so. We're gonna get to all of this right now. I'm sorry for not talking like a lot, like constantly. I don't know, I can't talk right now at the moment. Mostly because I tried recording this like 4 times, and I never got it right, literally. So, that's pretty much all. So basically, when you are done, try to get all the blue wines. Just check your work. Make sure you get it all. This usually doesn't take me that long, actually. If I'm not talking, I'll show you guys probably another time for me not talking, actually. Maybe. I'll show you guys how fast I am at doing this. So what I do for weapon reviews, basically, is that I choose the drop shadow option. And as you can see here, the weapon has a shadow. You can also choose, like, the glow or anything like that. You can choose like all these options right here. There's a lot of different ones. I don't use like all of these like pretty much at all. I only use a couple of things, and that's it. And after you're done, you press the save button on the done button. And what you do is click on the arrow button right here and click save the camera roll. I'm sorry, I can't say. And click on this button right here and click PMG. The reason why is that the weapon is not going to be transparent. It's going to have a transparent background if you click JPG. Click PMG and click on the weapon that you actually made. And there you go. So I have all of these actually, like a lot of them. So next, what you're going to do is look up a background on Safari. I'm not going to do that actually. So I have downloaded already some backgrounds. Click on the background. Just type in your Omnibar background 1280 by 720. The reason why 1280 by 720 is because That's the resolution for your actual YouTube thumbnail. At least that much. So, just click on the background that you want. It can be any background. I usually do sunburst, which because a lot of people actually do that. And it looks the best. So, click on... Wait, hold on. So, let me do that again. So, click on this button right here on the bottom right corner of your phone. Click on the plus button right here and post photo later for a library. And we're going to click on the Hellraiser right here. And there you go. We have the Hellraiser in that picture now. So... you think you're done right here, which you're not, because the weapon's way too small. You have to make the weapon at least visible, right, like this, so that's pretty good. And maybe you can rotate it if you want, and put it in the middle of the screen, and there you go. You pretty much got our thumbnail there. So that's pretty much how you make a thumbnail. So I'm going to show you guys how fast I can do this. I'm going to shut off now, because I need to stop talking for a second. Alright, here we go. Wait, what am I doing? I already made that. Eraser tool. Whoops. Okay. That's another thing, actually. You can actually just always go 100% hardness. Basically, just because it will make it look erasing a little bit blurrier. That's one thing I need to note as well. The words might pop up. Nature to erase everything except for the weapon, basically. And show you guys there. That's basically all you have to do. Always zoom in when you can't get something as easily. As you can see here, you might have a chance of erasing the bell. So I'm actually going to go make another PMG of one more weapon, actually. Of something a little bit more difficult, if I even have it. So here's the assault machine gun here. And as you can see here, there's a bit of a problem. Is that the arrow is actually over the weapon. So basically, what I do, just do what I told you guys to do. Just make a box around the weapon right there, or not, I just deselected that. Alright, extract that, and as you can see here, there's a little arrow in the way, so that's kind of a problem. Not super noticeable when you're actually in the finishing product of this. It's kind of a problem, actually, but you can't do anything about it. Pretty much everyone has this problem, actually, when you do this. So, just clear out everything right here, and we're gonna get... use the eraser tool when I need it. Am I good here? No, I have to deselect, actually. If you can't erase anything, that's because you actually selected something, so make sure to deselect if you have the option to. So, what I do here, since... okay, great. So, basically, what I do here is just to erase the part of the arrow that's not on the weapon, and just leave the rest of it right here. This is basically what I do, so that I go very carefully on this erasing part of the arrow that's not on the weapon. And you can barely even notice that thing. That thing's even there anymore when you actually make the thumbnail. So, you know, it's not really that big of a deal, really. Some weapons are actually very worse, even worse than this. So, you know, doesn't matter. I can't get the eraser on this thing. All right, there we go. That's good. And gets the eraser right here. And right here. I'm going to make a glow this time. Let's make it this color here. I'm going to choose a glow. And we're done with that one. And so let's make a PMG of that. Alright, so what you do next is that I am going to choose a background now. Actually, I'm going to choose a different background, so... and we're going to do the same thing with the assault machine gun right here. And just click check, because you can't, like, make it a background. Just click it and click transform again. That's what I recommend doing, so... alright, I'm failing. I'm trying to do this. Alright, there we go. Don't make it the weapon too big. Make it big enough so the viewer can actually see it. And make it in a position that you actually want it. The person's going to see the weapon either way, so that's good. And that's pretty much how you make a thumbnail. I'm pretty much done with this one here. And is that good? No, that's not good. Hold on, I can fix that. Okay, how can I make this? Is that good? You can also zoom out. Yeah, that didn't take good. So that's pretty much how you make your thumbnail, guys. There's a lot of different types of thumbnails you can actually do. It doesn't have to be a thumbnail like that. Maybe a thumbnail like this. I took a bunch of PMGs of weapons right here, and I put them all in one picture. You can look up some other PMGs of pictures online on Google. You can just look them up, and you'll get some pictures like this angry face I have right here, actually. So you can actually look it up on Google, and you can easily get it. So basically, here's something that's going to happen if you don't save the... you know, seeing it as a PMG. So I'm gonna save this as a JPEG, and we're gonna click that, and I'm gonna do the same thing as well. As you can see here, when I actually tried to put the Secret Forces rifle on there, I made a JPEG of that, and as you can see here, the thing is all white, and so make sure to always make a PMG, as you always do it. You can also make different types of thumbnails. You can make a bunch of weapon PMGs and put them all in one picture. That's how I make my YupiKai Play thumbnails, actually. So that's pretty much all you need to know of how to make thumbnails. So this is the thumbnail of this video right here too. So if you guys did enjoy this video, make sure to leave a like, comment, and subscribe. Comment down below if you guys have any questions about this. I can easily answer them. And yeah, guys, I will see you guys in the next Pixel Gun video.